Today, I'm going to show you how to integrate YouTube Music into Home Assistant. And if you're ready, let's go! For this, we are going to use the YouTube Music Player custom integration. To install it, we are going to use Hacks, click on Integrations, then click on Explore and Download Repositories. Here, we are going to look for YouTube Music, and we click on YouTube Music Player. Now, let's click on Download and Download. After this, let's go to the main page and click on Navigate and then Restart. Now, let's go to Settings, click on Integrations, click on Add Integration, and here we are going to look for YouTube Music Player. Click on it, and here we need to paste our cookie from our browser. For this, we are going to go to YouTube Music, press F12 on our keyboard, click on Network, and we are going to filter Browse. Let's give it a click. Here we are going to go to request headers and we are going to copy from accept to Google visitor ID. Just copy it and let's paste it in Home Assistant. Here we need to select our default output device. I am going to select living room and then click submit. And here we have it. Now I'm going to show you how to use it in an automation. For this, just go to settings, automations, create automation, and create new empty automation. First, let's choose a trigger. This time, let's say that I want to play a relaxing playlist after every meeting because I need to go back to my happy place. Let's click on add trigger and select calendar. Select the calendar you want and event end. Let's set a 5-minute timer after it's finished. Now, for the action, we are going to select call service. Here we are going to look for play media and let's select YouTube Music Player. Now we need to fill the content ID and the content type. For this, we are going to go to YouTube Music, click on your favorite playlist, because why not? And here we are going to copy the ID from the URL. Just copy everything after the equal symbol, equal symbol, and paste it and content ID. And for content type, we are going to use this part of the URL. And that's it. Now, to try it, just need to click on the three dots here and click on run. Now, what happens if I want to play my music in a different media player? You can see here that I didn't specify the media player to play in, it's just using the default settings. If you want to use a different one, you need to call an action before this. For this, just click on add an action, select call service. Here we're going to look for select source. In target, we are going to select YouTube Music Player. In source, we are going to put the name of the media player that we want to use. To get the list of media players that we can use here, just go to my website and copy this code to get all the available media players IDs. Now, open the developer tab, go to template, give the text a click, press Ctrl A in your keyboard, and paste the code. And now you have here the list of available media players that you can use. Just copy the one that you want to use and paste it on your automation. I'm going to set kitchen, and now this action needs to be executed first. So click on the three dots here and click on reorder. Just click up and then exit. Now, to try it, click on the three dots and click on run. And after that, just click here and click on run. This should make the YouTube Media Player to play on the correct device. There are a lot of combinations that you can use to automate this. Here are some examples of the things that you can do. Just remember, the order matters here. So you need to be sure that the actions in the automation are in the correct order. If you want to know more, go to the documentation. I will put the link in the description. Now, the best way to integrate this in the Home Assistant dashboard is to use a custom card. For this, we are going to go to Hacks, click on Frontend, explore and download repositories, and look for Mini Media Player. Click on it and download twice. Once it's finished, since this is just a card and not a whole integration, we just need to click Reload. To use it, we are going to click on the three dots here, click on Edit Dashboard, Add a Card, and here we are going to look for Mini Media Player. Now, we are going to use the example from the documentation to get the most of it. Just click on copy, click on show code editor, and paste it. Remove this part and select this and press Shift Tab once in your keyboard. Now, the best part here is that you can configure different actions from within the card. For example, I'm going to change the three buttons here to change the media player where YouTube Music plays the music, and the other two for my two favorite playlists. And after that, just click on Save. Now I can easily change the output device with a click or change the playlist. And that's it. You can control everything from here. One thing to notice though is that in the way that this works, if you want to stop the music, you need to configure the automation to stop the YouTube Music player rather than just stopping the music in the media player itself, because of how the integration works. So keep that in mind if you need to configure an automation to stop the music. Remember that you can use this in more ways than the one that I showed in the video. So if you want to know more, go to the documentation. I will put the link in the description. And now I want to know from you. Is there something that you would want me to cover in this video that I missed? Leave me a comment down below. And don't forget to subscribe to more content like this. I'll see you in the next video. Bye!